Okay, 1, 2, 3, go. M-O-B-O-O-G-I-E. Mo Boogie.
Mo Boogie.
With me. M-O-B-O-O-G-I-E. Mo Boogie.
Mo Boogie.
With me. MoBoogie.net. MoBoogie.net. That's what you get.
This is Ronnie with MoBoogie.net. We're here at the Fibarc Whitewater Music Festival here in Salida, Colorado. I'm sitting here with Dumps the Funk. How are you guys doing?
Pretty good.
How's the festival treating you so far? I know that you guys are wrapping it up, getting ready to roll out.
It's been great. We had a good time. The weather held up for us last night. We had a marvelous time.
Yes, sir. Great audience. The audience was amazing.
Yeah, I saw that. You guys always try to get as many girls up on stage as possible,
absolutely,
or what?
Absolutely, most definitely.
Absolutely.
So. Always.
Always?
Yeah.
Never get in the way, right?
Well, usually we try to, you know, we try to encourage like 6, 7, 8 girls. Yeah.
It was 8 last night. So, yeah, I heard Tony holler 8.
Yeah, it turned out about 17.
17 and a dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, you saw the dude.
No dogs this time, though.
Yeah. But we also had one time, we had a bunch of girls and a dog.
A lady with a dog.
A lady with a dog and a dude. That was and then a little boy came on. That was funny.
Yeah. Oh, right on. Right on.
Whatever that is.
So let's talk about your new EP that came out, 5-track Listen Here.
Yeah.
I know this is pretty hard to find, but people are digging on it. There's only 2 places to get it. Is that right?
At the gig is one.
At the gig.
And Louisiana Music Factory?
Yeah, Louisiana Music Factory.
You can order them from them, I guess, too. But, yeah. For now,
we don't have anything.
Not yet. We're working on it. It's coming.
Right on.
Yeah.
Any plans for full-length studio album coming up in the near future?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Actually, most of it is ready.
Yeah.
Yeah. We recorded about 13 songs.
Really?
Something like
13.
Maybe 12. Maybe 14.
A little bit more than that.
All right.
I'm not sure. But we just
we have enough
time restraints. And budget and whatnot, and we wanted to just get something out.
See, in other words,
people was wanting stuff. People was wanting to hear a Dumps the Funk studio record.
That's right. But in other words, see, a lot of you people out there think we're rich, but we're really not. So we really couldn't afford to put the whole full length album out.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
Make it black and white letter.
Well, right. I'm keeping it real.
All right. When keeping it real goes bad.
Now, you guys all have busy schedules outside of the band. I mean,
not no more.
Right now, we all pretty. Right now, this
we
is
must
our,
been fired from all our.
It's been our man party
this,
for a while.
This is the commitment.
But right now, we no longer play with the Neville brothers. Me and Ian and Nick. And I have no comment on what the.
Well,
what
not fired from the family though, right?
Well, I'll tell you an interesting thing. We always playing with all the fantastic musicians of the world and making money, and we decided to come together and do this project, and then we all got fired. So now this is our main thing here. We're keeping it real here, folks.
Oh,
all right. Well, so we need your support out there.
I mean, David Chappelle, where you at? You need to come back for a few extra episodes and get Raymond.
Please.
No, that's Chris Rock. Is that Chris Rock?
No, that's Dave Chappelle. Chappelle.
But keeping it real goes.
I just want to say one thing. I think, you know, this band is self-contained, self-managed at the time. We're doing everything ourselves, and I think we're doing a pretty good job of making this thing work.
We're just trying to get the word out, because what happens is we play, you know, we've played some phenomenal shows in front of a lot of people.
Right.
And what we're trying to do is we need to get that loyal fan base.
Right.
And we know we're very modest, but we know we are funky. And we know we're the funkiest band from the funkiest city in the world.
Absolutely.
You know, which is New Orleans, and you know, but I mean, it's like things take time for some, you know, for bands to really catch on and whatnot. And a lot of people know about the Dumps the Funk, but we just want to, you know, everybody who sees this or let people know. Go on our website, dumpsterfunk.com. Go on the MySpace page. Talk about it. Go on your other little chat sites. Do you want to see Dumps the Funk? You want to see the real funk? You got to add this. You know, because basically when this band came together, it was like, okay, let's do a gig. We had a gig at the Jazz and Heritage Festival, and my first thing was, okay, Ian's gonna do it. Let's see what either we're gonna need to get Tony Hall or Nick Daniels. Let's get both of them. You know, and Raymond Webber, and it just turned out we did like one gig maybe that year. And then the following year we played seasonal. Then the next couple of years we did like Jazz Fest stuff and some Mardi Gras shows. And then it was just too funky.
And then Katrina hit.
Exactly.
Yeah.
To not want to do it. And then the hurricane thing made a whole nother, you know, obviously everybody needed work a lot more after the hurricane, and there were more opportunities. And so here we are, and we just won't try to keep doing this. And
yeah, you know. So we need your support out there.
And we got to go catch a plane.
You're right.
No, we need your support.
All right, so where are you guys headed after this?
We're going home.
We're going home. Take a break, and then coming back to Colorado.
And then we're coming back. Where we playing?
First date is July 3rd in Vail.
Excellent.
It's that outdoor concert. I think it's like a Budweiser concert.
Y'all don't know what it is, but you might
know Gerald Ford Center or something like that.
That's it.
Nah, for real. I think that's what it's called.
Yeah.
Yes, the Gerald Ford Amphitheater. The next day we're in Breckenridge, Colorado, at the River at the Riverwalk PAC.
This guy came prepared.
All right, he got.
You know who's the spokesperson?
San Francisco Independent,
High Sierra Festival, and then Independent in San Francisco. Then we're doing a little 3-day trek up in some places where we would never live. We're up in Madison, Wisconsin, and Des Moines, Iowa, and
Kansas
whatnot.
City, Missouri.
It's wonderful people up there.
But it's warm up there now.
So it's warm up there now.
You know, we came up here when it was freezing.
Yeah, and then who knows? And I think we're trying to put together a full on like a 6-7 week tour. In August and September. So be on the lookout. Dumpster Funk gonna be coming somewhere near you. Coming to your town, come check it out.
You will smell it.
Check them out.
If you want some real funk.
Don't be scared.
Don't
it's okay.
Don't be scared.
And ladies and gentlemen, Tony has taken his shades off.
All right. Well, he's serious.
That's business.
Good morning.
Thank y'all.
Good morning, America.
We just want to let y'all know who everybody is in case you don't know exactly who the members of Dumpster Funk are. To my right.
Say your name.
Bass player, guitar player, singing fool. Has played with Emmylou Harris, Trey Anastasia, Dave Matthews, and friends, to name a few, Mr. Tony Hall.
Yeah!
On the guitar, to my left, has played with the Funky Meters, has sat in with numerous slamming, you know, bands like Lettuce and Soul Live and whatnot, and North Mississippi All-Stars, from Valley Street, New Orleans, Louisiana, the son of Art Neville, Papa Funk, founding member of the Meters, Ian Neville. My cousin. And to the left of Ian, all the way from New Orleans East, been living in a trailer for the past year and a half, just moved into his house. He wrote, like them, no, you know what? No, but guess what? His house looked better than it did before the storm. He done expanded the club. Has played with Harry Connick Jr., with Trey Anastasia, with Joe Sample. I think that was one of his favorite gigs recently.
Yeah, it was.
He's an underground jazz cat.
Yeah,
you know,
I'm on the
DL.
You know, I'm a smooth jazz cat. But he's funky.
Mr. Raymond Webber.
How you doing out there in television land, folks?
To my far left, all the way, was born in Waterproof, Louisiana.
Waterproof.
Born and raised in New Orleans, Louisiana, now currently resides in Georgetown, Texas, right outside of Austin. Has played with Boz Scaggs, Etta James, the Neville Brothers, the Wild Magnolias, to name a few. Mr. Nick Daniels III.
Yeah!
All right. And...
Wow.
Oh yeah, I played with my favorite ones. Okay, I played with Bonnie Raitt, Rolling Stones, played on a couple of their records, played with Keith Richards and Expensive Winos, to name a few. Neville Brothers, obviously. I'm from New Orleans, and I actually live in, I'm Nick's neighbor in Georgetown, Texas. Outside
don't
of Austin.
Don't Leave Out Rufus, that was a hell of a funky ass
band. Sure was.
That's not one of my favorite credits, though. It don't help me. It ain't one of my favorites. That's why I said my favorite.
But you took,
I could keep
he took Chaka Khan, please, in Rufus. Now, that's
and you know what? Six people bought that record, and probably nine know about it.
That's, you know, well, let me tell you, no.
You.
No,
but that, Tony likes that. Okay.
But that's, yeah. that's
all right. You know what? That was actually a great experience.
Yes.
Thank you, my
brother. At your age.
Yeah. I was a very young man. That was only 10 years ago. I was about 18. And my name is Ivan Neville. And we are Dumpster Funk. Thank you very much.
Dumpster Funk, keeping it real.
All right.
All right. This is Ronnie with MoBoogie.net here with Dumpster Funk in Salida, Colorado, signing out. Take care.
Thank you, baby.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All day, all night. You MoBoogie, that's right. That's right. All right. How do you like that? All right. Buy the record. Yeah, oh, boogie. Oh, boogie.